Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I would like to continue with the topic which I was previously mentioning regarding forgiveness, seeking forgiveness, the forgiveness of sins and tawbah. Now, the hadith was mentioned previously that the sins, the minor sins, are forgiven of a person by fasting and by doing different a'mal, which are mentioned in the hadith. Now, for the major sins, a person must repent. When he's committed a major sin, a major offense, he must repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely to get forgiven. And with regards to that, the hadith is mentioned in Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah that kullu bani adam khata wa khairul khata'in at-tawabun, that all of insan, all of bani adam, they are sinners, they commit mistakes. That's how insan is created, he makes mistakes. Wa khairul khata'in at-tawabun, the best amongst the sinners are the tawabun, those who seek forgiveness, those who seek repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive any sin, no matter how great it is. There is no sin that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't forgive except for shirk. And that is mentioned in Surah Nisa, in verse number 48, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not forgive that that someone has ascribed partners to him. And he may forgive other than that for whoever he wants. Now this shirk is when a person dies upon shirk, because we know if there's a mushrik, if there's a disbeliever, a mushrik, he accepts Islam, becomes Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive him because he has accepted Islam, he's repented from that. So there is no sin in this world where we cannot be forgiven. We just need to turn to Allah, ask for forgiveness, and seek this repentance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says that at-ta'ibu min al-dhanbi kama la dhanba lah, a person, a repenter, a person who repents from a sin, is as if he has not committed the sin. Allah will wipe this sin away from the account in such a way that there will be no, it will be as if a person has not even committed this sin. However, just I would like to mention the conditions. Allama Nawawi rahimahullah has mentioned three conditions for repentance, for a person's tawbah to be accepted. And these conditions are logical, and when I mention them, you will understand. So the first condition is that a person stops committing this sin. So whatever sin he is committing, he wants to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he must stop committing this sin and then repent. And he must have nadama, he must have remorse, and he sorrow that he has committed this sin, he has done something wrong. And the third thing is he should have the azm and the intention that he will not commit the sin again. With these three conditions, when a person repents, Allah will forgive the sin as if he has not committed that sin. However, when these three conditions are met, because Allah knows what's in the person's heart, what he intends. And if the same, even if the same act, the same sin is committed again, a person just needs to do tawbah. With these conditions, meaning with sincerity, with pure intention that he will not do it again, then if he indulges in it later on, he does tawbah, Allah will forgive. However, there's a fourth condition to the tawbah, when the sin committed is with regards to hukukul ibad. If it's with regards to hukukul ibad, then a person needs to get forgiven from the person as well. If, for example, a person has stole something from another person, he must return that. He has hurt someone's feelings, he must ask forgiveness from that person as well. So these are the conditions of tawbah, which I wouldn't say they're conditions, because it is logical. When we are asking for forgiveness, we must be stopping from that sin. We must have nadama and remorse, and we must be have the intention that we're not going to commit this sin again. So this is understandable. So when these conditions are met and we seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will forgive our sins, and it will be as if we have not even committed that sin. So this is a month of forgiveness. وهو شهر أوسطه مغفرة. The middle 10 days are of مغفرة, of forgiveness. So we need to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seek His forgiveness, and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our sins. May Allah give us the ability and forgive our sins in this blessed month. Ameen. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.